Hi, and welcome. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use StackState to easily troubleshoot a common issue in a Kubernetes environment using a simulated scenario. In this scenario, we have an application for an online sock shop where we introduce an issue every hour. What we see right now is the service map for all the clusters and all the namespaces in our Kubernetes demo environment. Let's start by drilling down and selecting the right namespace, named sock shop in our scenario. At this point, the service map will show only the services for the sock shop application, which in this case is deployed in both a multi-cluster and a single cluster setup. In this tutorial, we will use only the multi-cluster sock shop. Let's select these clusters as well. Let's take a look at our refined service map. You see an overview of all the services in the sock shop namespace for this cluster. By using StackState's unique time-traveling capability, you can actually go back in time to see how we got to this unhealthy state of our sock shop application. This helps us better understand how an issue evolved over time. If you hover over any relation or resource, you instantly get to see how that resource communicates with other resources in the environment. If you click on this relation, you can see one of the many paths StackState automatically detects between these two resources. In this path, the ingress service is backed by an ingress pod, which encloses an ingress container, which runs the traffic application, which connects to the Envoy process running inside the HTTP header proxy container, enclosed by the front-end pod, which is serving traffic via the front-end service. To visualize this as a topology, you can either click the Explore Relation button or double-click the relation in the topology visualizer. To get back to the service map of the sock shop application, you can simply click the back button, or you can use the smart history to go back to any of the previously visited pages. Now that we have covered some of the concepts we use in StackState, let's begin our troubleshooting exercise. Apparently, the ingress service is in a critical health state because the response time is higher than normal. Let's explore this in more detail by opening the ingress view. Although there are quite a few interesting, tailored insights we are seeing for this particular service, we are not going to dive into them right now. We are, however, going to focus on the provided out-of-the-box monitors, especially on the triggered monitors. In this case, this is the HTTP response time being above 3 seconds. Let's investigate this by clicking on it. Here we can observe the monitor timeline and the resulting health state at the moment we were looking into. The health state is critical, and it shows the supporting metrics, being the response time above 3 seconds. Scrolling down, we reach the related health violations section, which showcases all the health violations related to this issue, including the impacted resources. In this case, the impacted resources are the ingress service, the front-end service, the catalog service, and the catalog pod. Scrolling further down, we see the remediation guide for this specific issue. It shows the possible causes and the instructions to troubleshoot them. In this case, let's follow the first instruction, which tells us to find the deepest related health violation and follow its remediation guide on that resource. In this case, we follow the ingress to the front-end service, all the way down to the catalog service, and finally to the catalog pod. We can now see multiple health violations happening on this pod. Let's investigate the restarts for containers violation, since this looks like a plausible cause. Now we see the health timeline of this monitor indicating an issue. We also see the supporting metric going up. Let's scroll down to the remediation guide for this issue and see how we can fix it. In this case, it tells us to go to the events section of this pod's view. Let's go there. As you can see, we are now on the pod view, and the remediation guide we were following is now displayed on the right side. This allows us to follow the instructions step by step. Let's continue with the second instruction that tells us to find alerts like back off, failed scheduling, failed attach volume, or out of memory killed. We can hover over the event buckets to find these types of events, or just click the alerts link. We see the out of memory killed events, which indicate the container ran out of memory. We continue with the fourth instruction telling us that we can correlate the alerts with the metrics and with the deployments. By shift-clicking on specific times, we can set multiple markers. Let's do this for the events we found. By the way, you can delete a time marker by shift-clicking on it again. Let's continue following the remediation guide. Check the container logs for any explicit errors or warnings. We can find the logs widget below the events. This is shown for each pod, and will contain all the log entries for all the containers running on this pod. You can simply filter the errors by clicking the corresponding link. In this case, the errors tell us that the application had some timeouts of more than 5 seconds, and they all happened after the first time marker we set. This indicates that all the errors happened after the last deployment. We can now close this and move on. If we scroll further down, we see all the important metrics for this pod. In our case, the first section shows the CPU and memory usage. We can now easily correlate the memory usage and the alerts, validating the fact that this pod is having memory issues. Now we have to find the deployment that caused this. We have to scroll up to the events widget and find that deployment. In this case, we see a catalog deployment. Let's see the change which has been made. Apparently, the version of the Helm chart has been changed from version 0.3.5 to 0.3.6. Let's investigate if the memory usage was okay before this deployment to make sure this change is the real cause. To get more details about the event, we have to click on the deployment. Let's follow the link to the catalog deployment and investigate the memory usage of all the pods of this deployment. This way, we can compare the before and after deployment states. In the right-hand side panel, we now see a subset of the catalog deployment details, including the triggered monitor and the most important metrics. Let's scroll down to the memory usage. We can now clearly see that before the deployment happened, the memory usage was stable, and after the deployment, the memory leak was introduced. So there is indeed a memory leak present in the new deployment. This can be fixed with a rollback or a code fix. This concludes our tutorial on troubleshooting a common issue in the Kubernetes environment using a simulated scenario. I hope you enjoyed it, and I strongly advise you to try it on your own using our playground or request a free trial and try it with your own data. Last but not least, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.